Welcome back, everybody, to some more Besiege player-made creations. Now, I have more walkers for you in this episode today. I know some of you might be getting sick of walkers, but I just keep finding some amazing ones that I really want to showcase to you guys. And I find walkers just to be the coolest because, in my opinion, they're the hardest to make. It's really difficult to make a mechanical thing that walks on four, sometimes six, hell, sometimes two legs. And as you can see, we are back with something that looks quite similar to something I did before, which was the Mammoth. This is also the Mammoth, version 4.1, I believe, and it is a four-legged Mammoth instead of a six. So he has been improving this quite drastically. I don't even know if it's the same guy, but it looks very similar, so I'm going to say it is. I really like this design because not only can you go forward like usual, and it is very well balanced, but you can also spin, and you can churn. This is like the coolest way I've ever seen a vehicle churn ever. So it's a little bottom feetsies churn, and then you can keep walking if you want. And of course, it still has the amazing weaponry that it always did. So we're going to go over here and see if we can blow up some nice little houses. Uh-oh, my back leg just gave out a little bit. It's still okay, though. Somehow, oh, maybe not. Oh, God. Oh, shit! Gotta be careful when you're running with a Mammoth. They are quite heavy. I mean, these legs are pretty damn stumpy, but still, they're going to blow up after a while if you're not careful with your movements here, because you are essentially controlling it. Like, I can keep going and, you know, see, break it, essentially. Obviously, you don't want to do that. Oh, shit. There we go. Obviously, you don't want to do that, so you kind of got to get a finesse with it and figure out how each machine works before you actually are successfully walking with it. I actually find smaller steps to be a little bit better. It seems a little bit safer. There we go. Now we need to go into combat mode, which is quite neat with this vehicle. Essentially, it loses all its supports. You can see all its supports drop off. Its head actually tilts down now, which is a little different. And then you can shoot these things. And let's see if we can hit it. Come on, hit it! Yes, it's gonna hit it. First shot. And that one's going, that's not good. That one's going straight up. Let's shoot them before it blows me up. Oh God, okay. Okay, we're on fire. That's okay though. No big deal. There we go. We'll just shoot the balls as well. Oh my God, it looks so sad. Like, look at it. It is a don. Oh, it has freaking flame cannons as well now? I don't even remember how to use those. Well, he must have, hold on, that's weird. He must have re-keymapped the flame cannons. What is this? Oh, R. Interesting. Usually it's Y. Okay, now that makes sense. I was wondering why I couldn't use them. There we go. We got little flame cannons on the front as well. I mean, this thing is just a beast now. Definitely my favorite design. I don't know if I like the six leg or the four leg more. I do like the turning on this. That is a very unique idea to make the little wheels spin. So you just kind of got to go upwards and then you spin in place too. So you don't need much space. That is just such a cool design and it works very well. Okay, now we have a very, I don't want to say simple design because it's definitely not. A two-legged walker is easily one of the most difficult things to do, but it's a humanoid walker that can go back and forth. Essentially, that's it. And it's very easy to use. You just kind of strut along. It's not really taking steps. It's kind of, you know, sneaking its feet along. And it's very balanced, though, which is absolutely amazing. You can see it's using, actually, wind power to balance itself, it seems. And this top gyroscope thing seems to be how it's balancing itself, which is a brilliant design. You can also go backwards with it, and it does no problem going backwards either. And a sheep always, and it, all the time, sheep are just suiciding on that thing. But yeah, you can see it goes backwards, and then when you stop, it just, it's totally well balanced. You can go forward, backwards. I mean, it doesn't, it's an extremely stable design, and I want to see what people can create off of this base model, because it's really, really beautiful to look at. Okay, here's kind of a cheating one. I was looking for two-legged walkers, and as you can see, its tail is essentially a third leg. But it is a little T-Rex, and it's kind of cute, so I do like it. I would like to see a T-Rex that can actually balance itself. The tail definitely is helping it out here. It actually has a few other things you can do with it as well. So T and G turn the jaw. You can see that it has a little chomper as well. Quite cute. And then F and H can turn its tail as well, so you can kind of balance with its tail. You can see it sway left and right. Come here, my little buddies. I got something for. Oh, there's just one coming. Okay, well, here you go. Oh, he's avoiding it. Oh God, I can't turn that quick. Okay, let's keep going here. I'm not gonna be able to turn, obviously. So not the best design for killing things. Come on, please just walk into it. Yes, please just walk into my flames. I'll stomp on you. Well, that works good enough for me, I guess. I also found a reptile design, which is really quite cool. You move it forward and backwards with the legs, as you usually would, but you move the back to churn it, as a reptile usually would. So you can slightly churn. I mean, it's not churning overly aggressive, but most reptiles can't churn that quickly. Okay, so guys coming up here. So we do have a flamethrower and spikes as well, so we can just burn these guys as they come. There you go. Have that. Good. Goodbye, buddy. Now you can also move the tail with this design. I don't know what you. I guess for lashing. Actually, yeah, definitely for lashing people. Let me see if I can. There we go. Hit the one guy. Hit the other guy. Good stuff. That's actually a really cool. Well, I didn't even think about it. I didn't notice the actual blades on it, but it has a lashing tail that can attack people. And then it has horns that you can move up and down. I guess just wherever you want to jab people. It has a saw down there as well as a mouth. Just a really cool, simple design. I don't want to say simple as in, you know, anyone can make this, but for a walker, it seems quite neat, yet something that would be a good starter design. Okay, now I have one that I didn't even expect it to be like this. I just downloaded this one off a whim. It was called Spider, and it actually just pulls this along, which is a really neat way to give power and movement to a design. I mean, look at that. Oh god, I hit the fire, that's okay though. But it just works so good. Now, unfortunately, it's unrealistic because the beams are going straight through this middle part. But still, people figure that crap out and they use that to their advantage, which is all good to me because shit like this is just really cool to look at. Now, this is an eight-legged walker. Now, it's not pretty, but it's probably one of the most useful walkers I've seen. You can control it. Just like most other walkers, it moves forward. It's not very quick. It's kind of like a tank. You can also control each side differently, so you can turn it if you want. If we go the other way here. This actually is a lot of buttons to remember. Oh, what? God damn it, sheep. You guys just really like to die in my videos, don't you? So if we even this out, you do have to, you know, pay attention to how it's evened out. We can walk forward, and it's actually a repeating cannon shooter. So if we go up here, it's going to take a while. But if we go up here, we should be able to hopefully cannon these guys with three shots, as you can see. Alright, hopefully that's close enough. I don't know how far this thing shoots. I haven't even actually shot it yet, so I'm kind of excited for this. So here we go. First shot. Oh man. Unfortunately, not too far. That could definitely be better, but we're just going to have to move up here and try it again. Actually, I want to reload it first, because this is my favorite part. Alright, you go like this, which moves it into the middle, kind of squishes the balls together. No pun intended there. And then you drop the ball in, let it go. And then just, oh, okay, then we gotta let it go again. And there we go, we let it go, and it's in there, reloaded, and ready to go. So let's try and move up here, do another shot, and hopefully it works out. Okay, they're coming, that means we need to shoot now. Oh, what? That didn't even, oh god, okay, hold on. We gotta do this quick, let's reload here. Oh, it's not even working. Oh, there we go, okay, oh god. Okay, there we go. So, now we gotta reload it, unfortunately. I mean, my thing is pretty charred. I don't even know if it's gonna work, but, oh, come on. Please, let go of it! What am I doing wrong? Oh, God. Oh! Yep, that's not how to do it, but, hey. I think that's a little cooler anyways. Whoa! Oh, God. Where am I going? I love invincibility mode, man. It is the best thing I've ever seen. Oh, my God, this thing's adorable. This is another download on the whim. I don't even know how to use it. Oh, it even kind of hobbles like a cute little weasel. It's called Weasel, and as you can see, it's just a simple weasel design, and absolutely adorable. I mean, you can't get much cuter than this in Besiege form. All right, let's go stomp these motherfuckers with cuteness. I'm an adorable weasel. Bow down to me or die. Oh, I think they're kind of bowing down to me, you know? We're just being friends. They're dancing around me. I haven't hit any of them. Can I actually go backwards? No. Okay. I don't think so. What am I looking at? What is going on? Oh, God. I broke its neck. What the hell did I just do? I just sumo slammed them. All of them. And now I'm just kind of like... I don't even know. Okay! Okay, weasel, just relax. It's acting like a weasel now. Oh, Jesus Christ. Does invincibility mode ever screw up this game? And I love it. Okay, guys, that was just a few more quick walker designs I wanted to showcase to you guys. I hope you guys are enjoying these Besiege videos, because I love doing them. I know I've been doing a lot of walkers. I do want to start doing, you know, helicopters and all that other crazy stuff that people are making. But I just wanted to do one more episode of walkers for now until some more amazing ones come out so you guys can enjoy them. So thank you so much for watching, and I will see you in the next one.